So in the last class, what
sir,
were we talking about? Okay. So we have spoken about things like direct democracy, instruments. So we must have discussed right to recall, referendum, initiative and plebiscite. Okay. So moving on from that, the topic for today's class. Electoral systems, that is the election methods, the system to conduct election. We'll see some global systems, not just in India, some of them are in India also, but we should have understanding of how is an election system designed, the method to conduct election. So come here and know. Okay, so there are many methods, but essentially you will see there are only two methods. And everything else is a modification of these two basic methods. What, you know, I sometimes like to say two schools of thought. So whenever a country is thinking what should be the method of election which we should adopt, there are basically two thoughts. You have to choose which thought you want. And these two thoughts, these two ideas, or these two methods of conducting election are basically the two options that you have. Even when you go to vote, which I hope all of you will, the schedule is also announced, so you can plan everything accordingly. When you go to vote, there are two options you can choose. Actually, you can't choose. The constitution makers have chosen already. You think you still have those choices, but you don't. You can choose between the two options. You can either vote for this or you can vote for that. And they are mutually exclusive. If you vote for this, you can't vote for that. If you vote for that, you can't vote for this. So right from the very basic thoughts, we have to understand election methods. Conceptually, any method kya hai, that anybody can understand. See, think about it. When you go to vote in India, you will go to vote, Lok Sabha election. You know, there are two options that you can think of. You can vote for this or that. I'm not talking about two candidates. Candidates can be 100 also. What are the two options? Kisko vote dete hain aap? Kisko vote de sakte hain? Have you ever voted? So what can you think? You never thought only. Go and vote this time so that you have those thoughts in your head. Either you can vote for a candidate or you can vote for a party. There is no third option. Actually, there is no second option also. You may think you are voting for this or that, but actually you are voting for only one thing. In India, what do you vote for? That's the thing, even the greatest of the people, the civil service aspirants who claim to know a lot, even they don't know what they're voting for. That's the problem in this country. Logo pata hi nahi kisko vote kar rahe hain. You think you vote for a party, but you vote for a candidate. None of you voted for Narendra Modi. He is your prime minister. I mean, unless somebody is from Varanasi. You vote for a person, a candidate. Even when you think I will vote for a party, ultimately when you press the button, there is a person and there are many voters. You may vote when there is no party also, independent candidate. Koi zaruri nahi hai party ka hona. It is totally possible all the candidates are not even from a party. So you may think you are voting for a party, but actually you are not. Your vote is not counted for a party, it is counted for a person, a candidate. And that's what I'm talking about, the two schools of thought. When you vote for a party, it is called proportional representation. When you vote for a candidate, it is called first past the post system. Individually, people know each of the system, but they don't understand how they are different. So that's why conceptually, right from basics, we have to talk about it. Okay? Now, every other method is just a modification of this. So if you understand these two, rest is a cakewalk. They're nothing but a reform. Okay, let us see these two first. First we'll try and compare, and then we'll go in detail of each of them. So, we all know FPTPS. Let's talk about that first quickly. Now remember one thing. If you have got some idea right now already, that these are two opposite systems. In the sense that if you have this system, when you vote for a person, you can't vote for a party. When you vote for a party, you can't vote for a candidate. That means their advantages and disadvantages are going to be totally opposite of each other. So they are actually, you know, in a way, contradictory to each other. In the sense that, let's say I tell you system one. System one will have some good things, some bad things. If you want to solve those bad things, the solution is system 2. So the problem will be solved, but the system 2 itself will have some of its own problems. To solve that, system 1. That will have a problem to solve that, system 2. They're just opposite of each other. You can't have the best of everything. You have to choose. That's what the country has to choose. What are the bad things I am okay with? And what are the good things which are a priority for me? Right? So if a country has chosen a system, yes, it will have some problem. Even if you change, you will still have some other problems. Right? So keep that in your head. Let's see this basic understanding. And then we'll go in detail of each of them. So that we can understand other systems also. Now FPTPS, this is our system. You tell me, how is this election done? First thing, there is a constituency. Okay, that means there is a territory from where representative is to be elected. Candidates contest election, and the candidate who wins maximum votes wins. Simple idea, nothing extraordinary in this. Very simple. It's an election by plurality, not by majority. You need not have majority. You just have to have maximum number of votes. You have to come first. Okay, so we have that system here. Now because of this, see the problem that happens. And that problem you can see in the present Lok Sabha also. If you see the present Lok Sabha, the 16th Lok Sabha, if you see the single largest party, the single largest party is Bharatiya Janata Party, BJP. If you look at their vote share and you look at their seat share, how many votes they got, how many seats they have won. Okay, what is the vote share?
32%.
We have spoken about it so many times, 31% plus minus. Ek do aage piche ho. And what is their seat share? Bolo yaar. ऐसा आंसर देने वाले सोचा करो ना. दिस इज वेयर यू जस्ट टेल द पर्सन इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू दैट यू टोटली डोंट हैव एनी कॉमन सेंस. इफ अ पर्सन इज टेलिंग यू दैट यू नो वोट शेयर वॉज 31%, डू यू नो द सीट शेयर, आंसर शुड बी इन परसेंट ओनली. कैन यू नॉट सी द ट्रैक ऑफ द कॉन्वर्सेशन? यहां पर 280 का क्या मतलब है? हैव अ कॉन्वर्सेशन इन द स्पिरिट ऑफ द डिस्कशन. यू नॉट रॉन्ग 282, बट आंसर तो वैसा ही आना चाहिए ना. सो व्हाट इज 282 एज अ परसेंट? इट्स मोर देन हाफ. इतनी तो अकल हम सब में. लिटिल अबाउट 52%. नाउ इज दिस प्रोपोर्शनल बाय एनी एंगल? यू गेट 31% वोट्स बट 52% सीट्स. दिस इज टोटली डिसप्रोपोर्शनल, बट दैट्स ओके. वी नो दिस बिकॉज वी डोंट फॉलो प्रोपोर्शनल रिप्रेजेंटेशन सिस्टम. सो इट्स नॉट प्रोपोर्शनल, नो सरप्राइज. वी डिड नॉट इवन एक्सपेक्ट दिस टू हैपन. In the same Lok Sabha election, There is another party by the name BSP. A difference of only one alphabet. But we all know the story there. Their vote share was 4%. And their seat share, 0. Is this proportional? Is this even fair? At 31%, if I am getting 282 seats, but at 4% also I deserve some seats. But here, what? 0. But that's okay. We know this because we don't follow proportional system. But see the problem because of this. 31 out of 100 voters said, I like BJP. 4 out of 100 voters said, I like BSP. You know, 4% may sound very small, but this is 4% of India. Half of the world, the countries are smaller than this size. Aadhi duniya se bada ye number. What is 4%? You know how many voters are there in India? 90 crore. 90 crore voters. Without going in too much detail, how many vote, this and that. Simple number, 4% of 90 crore, it's roughly 3.5 crore people. 3.5 crore people are saying, I want BSP. I believe in their ideology. Who is representing these people in the house? 3.5 crore log aapke desh ke koi represent kar raha hai. Is there anybody who's their voice? No. What kind of democracy is this then? So obviously this is a problem. Right? Because the electoral strength and the political strength is not matched. As you can see, bigger parties get over-represented and the smaller parties get under. Here, no representation only. Do you understand electoral strength? Strength in the electorate. How many voters want me? And my political strength? What is political strength? Seats in the house? Which is the politically strongest party today? BJP. Why? Because they have maximum seats in Lok Sabha. There is no other reason. Because they won the seats. Now, can I say, looking at this, that the true wish of the people is reflected in Parliament of India?
No.
You tell me, can you say this? No. The true mandate of people is not reflected. Solution of this is proportional representation system. What happens in that? There is no constituency. There is no candidate. There is only political party. People vote for parties. No constituency, no candidate. In fact, the entire region is one constituency. The whole nation is one constituency, or the whole state will be one constituency. And then, based on the percentage of votes the party gets, proportional seats are given. So if the party gets 10% votes, they get 10% seats. If a party gets 4% votes, they get 4% seats. If they get 31% votes, they get 31% seats. It's kind of very obvious in the name, proportional representation. Okay? So the benefit you can see that now the electoral strength and the political strength will be matched. True mandate of people will be reflected in the house. When your actual people's voice is 31%, your voice in the house will also be 31% only. You will not have more strength. But see the problem. And to understand the problem, let me explain the system a little bit more, that how it will actually take place in India. So I told you that there is no constituency. Political parties will contest election. All the people will vote for parties. Let us say a party gets 10% votes in the country. So I'll give them 10% of Lok Sabha. 10% of Lok Sabha is, let's say, 55 seats. So they get 55 seats. Who are these 55 people? That's an important question for us. You did not select them. Who selects them? The party. Okay, so let's say you voted for this party and in total party got 10% votes. So they have appointed 55 people from their party. Which of these 55 is your representative? All of them. That means none of them. When you have 55 representatives, you don't have a representative. If the road outside your house is in poor condition, if the street light is not working, if the water is not coming, electricity supply is a problem, whose collar will you go and hold? All 55. That means none. Accountability has to be fixed. Right? The buck has to stop at one place, not at 55 places. So that's the problem of this system, that there is no link between people and MPs. You don't have a direct link of accountability because your link is with the party. Now what is party? Party kya hota hai? You have to hold party accountable. Who? Party president? What is party? Party is a hypothetical entity. But when it's people, you can directly link. Got the idea? So, there is no direct link of accountability between the people and the members of parliament. And the solution of this problem? FPTPS. Because in FPTPS, you vote for a person. So, there is a direct link of accountability. You voted for me. So I am responsible. In otherwise, you voted for party. Hold party responsible. Whose party? So do you see how these are two counterpart of each other? The problem of one, the solution is the second. But that also has a problem. The solution of which is the first one. So quick recap. Because this is the basic premise on which we have to develop our thoughts. You tell me, what is the biggest advantage of proportional representation? अरे नाम में ही है ना हाँ व्हाट प्रोपोर्शन
सीट्स इलेक्टोरल
या द इलेक्टोरल स्ट्रेंथ एंड पॉलिटिकल स्ट्रेंथ इज मैटर द प्रॉब्लम नो डायरेक्ट लिंक ऑफ अकाउंटेबिलिटी हेंस द बेस्ट बेनिफिट ऑफ एफपीटीपीएस डायरेक्ट लिंक ऑफ अकाउंटेबिलिटी इज देयर बट द प्रॉब्लम जस्ट दूसरे सिस्टम को समझ लो सब इट्स ऑल वन पैकेज सो इफ यू गॉट दिस Let's actually begin our discussion. One by one. First, proportional representation system. Quick recap, you tell me how is this election done? First, there is no constituency. There is no candidate. Only political parties. People vote for parties. And based on the percentage of votes, proportional number of seats are allotted. Simple. Okay, advantages. First point, you already know, write it on your own. First point. What is the first point? The name? Bolo? Political parties are properly pura sentence likhna bhi aana chahiye na don't throw dialogue at me political parties are properly represented their electoral strength and political strength is matched the true mandate of people is reflected in the house there are many ways to say the same thing okay this we know next point because of this Let us consider the second point also. See, right now, a party has got 4% votes, but they've got nil seats, zero. Okay? Had it been proportional representation, then this party will get 4% seats. What is 4% of Lok Sabha? About 22 seats. Boss, that's a lot. If you are getting 22 seats in Lok Sabha, you are a big party in India. Right now they get zero. That's how unfair the system right now is for the parties. Anyway, so you get 22 seats. That means, boss, forget 4%. You get 1%. I'll give you 5 seats of Lok Sabha. That means, sir, forget 1%. You get 0.2% votes of the country, sir. 0.2%, I'll give you one seat of the house. Because that's what it's worth. That means, forget 3.5 crore votes. Get 20-30 lakh votes only. I'll give you a seat of the house. That means you don't have to have huge support. And even after that, you don't get a seat here. Itna bada support hai, zero seat. In proportional representation, even if you have small support, that small voice also will be heard in the house. So can you see, proportional representation system is a system which is suitable to promote minority interests. Yahan pe to minority gayab ho gayi. It's gone. Unless you are more than 3.5 crores, you are not getting anything. Here, 20-30 lakhs, okay, you have a seat in the house. The interest of minorities are protected better in this system. Their voice is heard better. So if a country is thinking of minorities, their interests, this is a natural system they should consider. Because even a small group of people will have a voice. Okay. Further, let's see if you can see it yourself. Do you realize that proportional representation system, in that system, if it is adopted in India, the voter turnout will increase? Can you see that?
Yes.
Yes, why?
Each vote has more value.
Voter turnout will increase significantly. Yes. Because people can vote from anywhere. In this year's election, we all know, a lot of you are not going to vote. You also know. You will not vote. You'll give hundreds of excuses. Right? You will not. But people of this country, a lot of them are not able to vote because people have migrated. Their vote is registered somewhere else. They have to be physically present in the constituency because there's a concept of territory. You're electing a representative for the territory, so you have to be there. So if you're not there, you can't vote. In proportional representation, there is no constituency. The whole country is a constituency. So wherever you are in your constituency. Just vote for the party. Doesn't matter. You see, this is one big reason why many people cannot vote in India. Because your vote is not where you live. And people don't bother to get it changed, etc. So many things. So people can vote from anywhere. Further, do you also see, there will never be a by-election. क्योंकि खुद से देखना शुरू करो बेटा आज के बाद कोई क्लास नहीं है यू ऑल्सो नो दैट सो नाउ यू आर ऑन योर ओन एटलीस्ट हियर आई एम स्टिल मेकिंग यू सी थिंग्स वेरी सून नोबडी इज देयर टू मेक यू सी थिंग्स यू हैव टू रीड खुद से सपने में सोच लो यू हैव टू हैव दैट एबिलिटी नाउ कैन यू सी दैट देयर विल बी नो बाय इलेक्शन यस बिकॉज सी फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन आर रैंडम थिंग विच आर टेलिंग यू पार्टी गॉट 10% वोट्स They were given 55 seats of Lok Sabha. One of them died. No problem. You already voted for the party. Party has not died. Party will appoint 56. They appointed 55. One more. The problem comes when you vote for the person. When you vote for the person, person dies. Now what do we do? But when you voted for the party, party is alive. There is no concept of a by-election. Which is also a good thing. However, issues and concerns. वो तो हमेशा ही रहेगा. First point. You know the first point, so straight away write it, please. What is the first point? बोलो जोर से. There is no direct link of accountability between people and the members of parliament. The link of accountability is with the party and indirectly on the person. Okay, further. See, The purpose of telling you the basic premise right in the beginning is that they have a fundamental positive and a fundamental negative. You can never get rid of the fundamental negative. The only way to do that is to change the system completely. But that will also have a fundamental negative of its own. You can never get rid of it unless you change the system back to the original one. So, no matter how much we modify the system, unless you switch between these two, the problem, the fundamental problem will never go away. This is the basic idea of telling you that. That no matter how much you reform, basic problem solve kaise hua dusre system se. So if I keep reforming this, unless I change, the basic problem will never go away. Because that's how the system is designed. This is what is called systematic understanding of a subject. Individually, everybody knows the election methods. But how they compare, you know, and how it's a concept around that. So even further discussion that we'll have, don't forget the fundamental problems and the fundamental advantages. Because the others are nothing but a reform of this. Anyway, so more problems of proportional representation. See, understand this. This party here, just for example, because we've written it, I'm picking it up. It is known to promote a particular type of politics in India. What is called? क्या कहते हैं इस तरह की राजनीति को? Identity based politics, right? Which in a narrow sense, here you can largely see caste based politics, but it's identity based. We all know this, right? कि आप दलित हैं, आप मुस्लिम हैं, आप ये हैं, मतलब this is the kind of politics. I'm not saying right or wrong, I'm saying they promote that. That's their ideology, and 4 crore, 3.5 crore people are in sync with that also. ठीक है? We all know identity based politics, is it a good thing? Aapko kya lagta? It's good? No, it's not good. 3.5 crore people believe in that. It's not a small number. Whether you believe it's right or wrong, the point is it there. It's part of our life. And a big part of our life. Right now, even that big a voice, who's listening to that voice in the house? Is anybody listening to that voice? No. Now imagine, you have proportional representation. Suddenly, this voice, which was not even heard in the house, suddenly has become such a loud voice. 22 seats in the house. What has happened? You have just given more promotion to such kind of politics. It has suddenly become a major voice of the house. Because see, understand this. Right now, think from the perspective of this party or a leader of this party. 3.5 crore people are supporting me. I don't get a seat in the house. In proportional representation, forget 3.5 crore. Even if I get, you know, 1/10 of that, 1/20 of that, I get a seat in the house. That means, let me bring up, you get 20 lakh votes, sir, 30 lakh votes, you'll get a seat. That means I don't need to bring together so many people. I just need some support. That means I have to unite people somehow, not 3.5 crore people, but just 30 lakh people. And that is also a big number, 30 lakh, toh bahut kuch ho jayega. Now, how do I unite people? What does a political party want? Political party wants to unite people. Unite not all the people, some people, that they should vote for me. In your thought, you should think only of me. That's the kind of unity they are talking about. How do you unite people? Bring an issue that is close to them. If I talk of Pakistan, everybody gets united. Right? But for other issues, we are not all united. But for Pakistan, sab unite ho jate. Then even political parties unite. Arvind Kejriwal apna anshan chhod dete. That, I'm with the government now. for 2 days. That's what I'm talking about. You have to bring an issue to unite people. And you know, the easiest one is identity, because that is the closest to you. Climate change. You think that's really bothers people of India? Now, for you, it's important maybe to write an answer, but does it bother people that they will consider climate change while they vote? Nobody's bothered. So it unites very few people, the intellectual class, you know, they get united on climate change. So you have to bring an issue. The easiest issue to unite people is their identity. Now, what identity? By the way, climate change is also an identity. You just have to look at it that way. Everything is an identity. Every issue is an identity. Right? How? Any issue you pick up, it doesn't bother everyone. Those who are bothered, it's their identity. Like Delhi getting statehood. It's an issue of identity of the people of Delhi. It doesn't unite people of Tamil Nadu. They're not bothered Delhi gets statehood or who cares. But people of Delhi, they are bothered. It's their identity. Now, the first identities we all develop. Let's look at a child. When the child is born without anything, right? There's no identity the child has. It doesn't even know this is my hand. Forget knowing my country. It doesn't know my fingers, anything. So what is the first identity the child develops? My mother. अरे मेल फीमेल तो बहुत बात की बात है. 7 साल की उम्र में पता चलता है उसको. कई लोगों को 15 साल में पता चलता है. नहीं, नॉट अ जोक. बट द फर्स्ट आइडेंटिटी, सी व्हाट इज आइडेंटिटी, दैट व्हाट इज माइन. बिफोर इवन द चाइल्ड रियलाइजेज माय बॉडी बाउंड्री, द चाइल्ड रियलाइजेज मम्मा, देन पप्पा, देन मी, देन माय सिस्टर, my brother, my neighbor, my building, uncle, auntie, relatives. Then comes my school, my friends, my district, my language, my state, my religion, my caste. If time is left in your life, my nation. And why should we stop at that? My planet. So that's why I understand this. You may have this thought that, oh, he's so passionate about religion. They don't think of nation. I think of nation. You are also a level lower in your evolution. You tell me honestly, do you think of the world? You may not think of religion and caste the way passionately some people think, because you think you're very secular, this and that. Do you think of the world? Are you bothered by climate change the way he's bothered about his religion? If I tell you climate change is happening, does it change your way of life? Do you start changing your behavior in a daily basis? You go and tell people, hey, your religion is under threat. Oh my God, I'll kill people for that. Climate change doesn't bother people. It's your level of evolution. To which level you have developed your identity. If you have developed a global identity, which is very rare in India, that's why they say, are kya baat kar rahe ho? Real issues are these issues. People are dying here. Yeah, okay, they are dying. No, but nobody is saying they are not dying. The cow is also dying. Bahut si cheeze mar rahe hai desh mein. So, when you have these kind of thoughts in your head, ponder. My point is this, that when you want to unite people, and all you want to unite is some very few people, not the entire nation, because you don't have that much capability anyway. What is the first issue that you can hit people with? When you want 10, 20 lakh people united? Their identity around caste, religion, region, language, these kind of things. Because this is where people become passionate. If you try to unite them on national level, the only thing you can think of in India is Pakistan. अदरवाइज नेशनल इश्यू पीपल हैव नो सेंस. खतरा दिखना चाहिए हमेशा, एक खतरा, या तो रिलीजन को खतरा हो, कास्ट को खतरा हो, या देश को खतरा हो, खतरा होना चाहिए. देश का खतरा तो पाकिस्तान नहीं करेगा तो कुछ पता ही नहीं चलेगा किसी को, nobody will realize the खतरा. So that's what I'm talking about. If you have proportional representation, it kind of promotes and strengthens parochial identities in the masses. You understand parochial identity? What is parochial? You've heard the word parochial, right? It's not the first time. Narrow-mindedness. It creates more narrow-mindedness because it promotes that kind of politics. Another point related to this, if you have actually understood what I'm trying to say, you'll understand this also immediately. Do you see that because of this, there'll be a tendency that the larger parties will get fragmented into smaller parties? Can you see that? Yes. जिस दिन सीख जाओगे ये सारी चीजें, you are ready for the exam. Because books don't explain anything. They just write one line. I can see on your faces you could not understand. A lot of you, some of you I can see your eyes are sparkling. Oh, some of you are, oh, larger parties will break down. Yes. Again, see the same logic here. Right now, let's say I'm a leader of this party, BSP. I'm not the supreme leader. I'm not Behenji. I am some leader. Right now, my party has got support of 3.5 crore people, but 0 seats. What are the chances I go to the house? 0. Okay? Now let us say we have proportional representation. My party has got 3.5 crore votes. 22 seats in the house, sir. Now what are the chances I'll go to the house? What are the chances? Some chance. But do I have 100% chance? No. Who has 100% chance? Madam Mayawati. Well, she is the leader of the party. Sabse pehle khud jayengi. So if I am the 22nd highest leader, then I will get in. So there is some chance. It's better than the other system. Now imagine, I start thinking, think like a politician here. I am a part of this party. There is not a very great chance that I will get in the house, even if the party has got 3.5 crore support. Let me break the party. Let me form my own party. Because I also have some support in the masses. So with that much support, my party will definitely get one seat. And when my party gets one seat, how much chance is with me to beat that person? It's me only. Because I have that much support. See, think like a politician, you'll get all these ideas. So naturally, there's a motivation to break the parties. Because your seats are based on party, not individual. So if you have a party of your own, you have a good chance to get the seat. Even with less support. Yahan pe to itne bade support mein kuch nahi milta. That's why, do you see a tendency in your country? Right now, what is the tendency? Parties want to join together. Even if they have separate identity, they want to join. 22 parties have come together, 22 party. Maha maha ghatbandhan hua hai. For what? No, for what? What is their goal? What is their goal? Are they saying our goal is development of India? What is their goal? Anti-Modi, Modi got aana. Wo khulle mein kehte hain, so this is the level of politics in your country. Jahan goal hai aadmi hatao. At least second goal you say development, employment will be created. No, ek hi goal hai, Modi hatao. Ye kaisa goal hai yaar? Is he such a big person for you then in the nation that's got hatao? Hota hai aisa, right? Anyway, so that's what I'm talking about. That the tendency right now is to grow big. Because unless you are big, you can't fight. Whereas in this system, there is an opposite tendency to keep breaking the parties. Because then you ensure seats for yourself. समझ में आया।